Lately, social media has been buzzing over the Volonaut Airbike, a jet-powered hoverbike claiming it can hover and reach speeds up to 200 kilometers per hour. With its futuristic design straight out of a sci-fi movie, this thing grabbed people's attention fast. But alongside the excitement, a lot of people started questioning whether it's actually real, especially after Volonaut dropped a new promo video featuring a rider dressed as a stormtrooper, making it feel even more like a scene from Star Wars than an actual tech demo. Some are calling it a gimmick, others flat out labeling it fake, so today, let's break down where those doubts are coming from and what we actually know about this airbike so far. At first glance, the airbike's design looks super sleek and minimalist. Unlike most hoverbikes that rely on four exposed rotors for lift and stability, this one uses jet propulsion without any visible propellers. That's extremely rare, since those rotors usually serve a double purpose, keeping the vehicle airborne while also stabilizing it mid-flight. With the airbike, its stabilization system isn't clearly visible. Sure, the promo shows some small flap-like components, but without any explanation of what they actually do, it's hard to guess how this thing stays balanced while maneuvering. The shape is also kind of rounded, which makes some people wonder if it might roll over mid-air. In personal flying vehicles, balance is one of the biggest challenges, especially if the rider shifts position or there's a sudden gust of wind. That's why, in real hoverbike test videos, you'll see pilots barely moving at all to maintain control. Another thing raising eyebrows is how little technical information is out there. Volonaut claims the airbike uses jet propulsion, possibly microturbines or ducted fans, but so far there are no specs. We don't know how long it can fly, its lift capacity, what type of fuel it uses, or how the control system actually works. Interestingly, they also say the airbike has an advanced flight computer that makes it so easy to fly, even a beginner could handle it. But a bold claim like that without proper data or a transparent tech demonstration naturally leaves people skeptical. Then there's the promo video itself, which honestly adds to the suspicion. One thing people quickly noticed, there's no engine sound while it's flying. If it really runs on jet propulsion, it should be loud. Plus, in some shots, the vehicle's shadow on the ground looks inconsistent, making a lot of viewers suspect the footage might be CGI or at least heavily edited. The cinematic style of the video, with no full takeoff or landing sequences shown, also makes it feel more like a concept visualization than a real-world flight test. But if you think about it, the idea behind the airbike isn't that far-fetched. If you compare it to existing tech like jet suits, which use multiple microturbines on the hands and back to generate lift and control, Volonaut seems to be trying to combine all those components into a single vehicle, essentially turning a jet suit into a flying motorbike, using carbon fiber materials, 3D printing, and a lightweight minimalist design that prioritizes efficiency. The concept of the airbike actually makes sense. Its balance could potentially be maintained by adding extra microturbines around the body, while a flight computer automatically adjusts the thrust, kind of like how modern drones use stabilization systems, but on a much bigger, more powerful scale. So even though we don't have many official details yet, the basic concept isn't technically impossible. The real challenge would be pulling it off safely and reliably in real-world conditions. In short, people are skeptical about the airbike because of its ultra-futuristic design, lack of clear technical information, a promo video that feels a bit too perfect, and practical questions about how it would work in actual environments. But on the other hand, with today's advancements in microturbines, 3D printing, and smart flight controllers, a project like this isn't entirely out of reach. And let's not forget, Tomasz Patan, the person behind Volonaut, isn't just some viral gimmick creator. He's one of the minds behind the Jetson ONE, a personal flying vehicle that actually exists and made headlines not too long ago. Jetson ONE proved that personal aerial vehicles aren't just science fiction anymore, so if anyone could take a crazy-looking concept like the airbike and turn it into something functional, it's probably him. So is the airbike real, and ready to fly like we saw in the video? That's still a big question mark. But maybe, this is just a glimpse of what personal transportation could look like in the future, the kind of thing we've only seen in sci-fi movies until now. What do you guys think? Is it still just a dream, or the start of a transport revolution? Drop your thoughts in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.